Well, one of the most direct effects of this universality finding was it really opened up research on emotion in the face. And emotion more generally, because for much of the 20th century, people had not studied emotion because it was considered something inherently subjective. Right. That you could not measure. And if you think about what's been going on in psychology during this time, behaviorism, everything has to be observable. How could you study something as private and as an emotion? This finding on the face suddenly suggested, which earlier research in psychology had not suggested, that there was reliable information about emotion in an observable modality in the face. So it became clear that we could study emotions from the outside, not just from the inside. And in order to kind of potentiate this work, make it more likely, Ekman and Friesen developed a measurement tool to enable the objective studying of facial behavior from the outside. They developed the facial action coding system. The acronym for that is FACS, or FACS, which is an elaborate, detailed observational system. Observational meaning it relies on human observation to code all observable facial movement without saying what it is, so it's purely descriptive. And that really opened up an enormous amount of opportunity in emotion research, mm-hmm. to study emotional behavior objectively, to do it without drawing people's attention to it, you know, because you could video record and then code the behavior later.
Each emotional expression has a unique pattern of facial.
Right, but it's important to understand that FACS is not just for emotion. FACS is for describing facial movement. You can see which actions occur together to describe any expression on the face. So I'm going to give another little demonstration right now. Let me back up. FACS describes all facial muscle actions in terms of arbitrary action units. So it separates all facial behavior in terms of what each muscle does. So if I lift the inner corner of the eyebrow, that's one action. Each action has an arbitrary numeric code. So this is action unit one. This is two. This is four. This is five. This is six. I could go through the whole face. There are 44 different action units to describe the individual components of facial action. And then you can see whatever the face does and describe it in terms of these components. So if I take one of the emotion expressions that I modeled earlier, like anger, this has the brow lower, which is action unit four. Lifting the upper eyelid is action unit five. Tightening the lower eyelid is seven. Pressing the lips together and pushing the chin up is 17 and 24. So we have a 4, 5, 7, 17, and 24. So you can describe any facial action. And one of the interesting applications of the facial action coding system has been in computer animation. In fact, it's become the gold standard in the visual effects industry for developing virtual beings, virtual actors. You know, it was used in Avatar, it was used in Harry Potter, it was used in any animated creature. They use the action units as the basis for animating their faces.
So in fact, that leads to my next question, which is, can you tell us something about how you've applied FACS, or facial action coding system, in your own work?
It's been really interesting, because my original intent was to study emotion, and that's why I got into studying the face. So I've applied FACS to my own research on emotion, where I've looked at things like the role of anger in heart disease, but that was my dissertation research. I've also looked at the relationship between facial expression and people's reports of emotional experience, and how emotions change as a function of, more recently, meditation training. So that's some of my research. But as a result of becoming expert in FACS, I've learned that a lot of people are interested in this measurement tool for other reasons. So I've trained animators, like people who do visual effects animation. I worked on the television show Lie to Me, which was on from 2009 to 2011 on Fox. And this was a drama based on really Paul Ekman's career. So the lead character in that was a deception detection expert. And the field of deception detection depends a lot on facial movement detection. So I was a scientific consultant on that show, reading the scripts, coaching the actors, etc. So it's really run the gamut from basic research to something really applied, like in the entertainment industry. And sort of a continuous thing throughout all of those is FACS, the facial measurement, and the kinds of people I've trained in that.
Great. Well, thank you. I hope you've enjoyed this and also see that how psychology can be applied in a lot of different areas in ways that you may not have expected.